If you are getting fail to open descriptor file error while launching Nightingale on your PC, then you are at the right place. We have got the best ways to fix the issue. Welcome back to Silicophilic, your go-to source for tech tips and fixes. Method 1. Verify the game files. Missing or corrupted game files mostly cause a fail to open descriptor file error while trying to launch Nightingale. To fix this, verify the game files. This process should fix the corrupted files and download the missing game files. Here is how you can verify the integrity of the game files from the Steam platform. Head to the Steam library, right-click on the game and open its properties. Go to the Installed Files tab and click on the Verify Integrity of the Game Files option. Wait till Steam verifies the game files and download the missing file or fix the corrupted game files. Once done, launch the game and check. Method 2. Restart Nightingale and your PC. You can also restart your PC and try to launch the game afresh. This can fix minor bugs and glitches that can be responsible for the issue. Control plus Shift plus Escape to launch Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab and look for any process related to the game. Select the End Task option to close all the processes related to the game and Steam. Now restart your PC. Once your PC restarts, try launching the game. Method 3. Check your internet connection. You need a stable internet connection while downloading and installing Nightingale. So check your internet speed from speedtest.net. If you have an unstable and poor internet connection, then contact your service provider. You can use a stable broadband connection while downloading and installing the game. You can also restart your router or modem and see if this can fix the issue. Method 4. Check the game server status. Next, you can check the Nightingale server status. You can check the game's X handle or the Steam server status from here. If there is any server outage, then wait for some time and then relaunch the game and check again. When the server becomes up and live again, try to launch the game and see. Method 5. Forward port in the router for Nightingale. Forwarding port can ensure a stable network connection and make it faster. Before forwarding port, you should keep these handy. Your router's IP address, the IP address of your gaming device, the TCP and UDP ports. The network ports for Nightingale for Steam are TCP 27015,27036, UDP 27015,27031 to 27036. As PC ports are not yet available, so we are showing the process using these Steam ports. Log into your router, look for the router's port forwarding section. Enter the IP address of your PC or gaming device in the dedicated field in your router. Next, enter TCP 27015,27036, UDP 27015,27031 to 27036 ports for Nightingale in the respective fields in your router. Once done, reboot your router to apply the changes. When you are done following those steps, your ports should open. Method 6. Flush DNS and reset network settings. Flushing the DNS will clear all the DNS cache and reset the network settings. If you are getting the error due to network-related issues, then the error can be fixed this way. Here is how to do so. Type cmd in the search menu and right-click on the command prompt. Select to run as administrator. Copy and paste the following commands in the elevated command prompt window. Press the enter button after each command. ipconfig/flushdns, ipconfig/release, ipconfig/renew, netshintipreset, netshwinsockreset. Once done, restart your PC and then launch the game. Method 7. Change the DNS settings. Sometimes the DNS settings may not be configured correctly. Due to this, you may get errors while gaming. So change the DNS settings and see if this can fix the issue. Open Control Panel using Windows Search. Change the view by to large or small icons. Select Network and Sharing Center. Next, click on Change Adapter Settings. Then right-click on Your Internet Connection and select Properties. Double-click on Internet Protocol Version 4. And select the Obtain an IP Address Automatically and Obtain DNS Server Address Automatically options. Now see if this has fixed the Ethernet connection error, or else go to the next step. Next, select Internet Protocol Version 4 and open its properties. Then click on the Use the following DNS server addresses option. Set the value of the preferred DNS server address to 8.8.8.8. Then set the alternate DNS server address to 8.8.4.4. Click on OK to save the changes. Now launch the game and check. Method 8. Disable firewall or allow the game through the firewall. Firewall and your antivirus program can also interfere with the game and create issues. So you can temporarily disable firewall and antivirus. Since it is always recommended not to disable firewall and antivirus as your system is vulnerable to malicious threats without them, make sure to enable them soon after. Here is how to disable Windows Defender Firewall. Type Windows Defender Firewall in the Windows search box and select the top option. Click on Turn Windows Defender Firewall on or off. Click on Turn off Windows Defender Firewall, not recommended for private and public network settings. Save the changes by clicking on OK. In case you use Windows Security, type Windows Security in the search menu and select the first option. Select Virus and Threat Protection. Click on Manage Settings from the Virus and Threat Protection settings. From the next window, turn off the toggle for real-time protection. From the next USE prompt, select Yes. If you have any other third-party antivirus software, make sure to turn it off too. Alternatively, you can allow the game through firewall and your antivirus program. Here, we are showing how to allow the game through Windows Security. Open the Windows Security app using the search menu. Now click on the Firewall and Network Protection option. After that, tap on the Allow an App through Firewall option from the right side pane and then press the Change Settings button. Next, click on the Allow another App button and then press the Browse button to select the game .exe file. Click on Open and then click on the Add button. You will now see the game under the list of allowed apps and features. Tick the checkbox associated with the game and enable it on both public and private networks. Once done, you can press the OK button to save changes. Finally, you can relaunch the game file and check if it is loading properly. Method 9. Close unnecessarily running programs. Sometimes streaming and downloading other programs can compete for resources and cause issues while downloading and installing games like Nightingale. So close unnecessary apps to free up bandwidth for Nightingale. Open Windows Task Manager. Go to the Processes tab and right-click on the processes you want to close. Select the End Task option. Repeat the same for each task you want to kill. Then exit the window. Method 10. Update your Windows OS. Windows updates can help resolve issues with game performance. Also, updating Windows to the latest version ensures your computer runs with the latest security and performance enhancements. Type Check for Updates in the search menu and select the top option. Click on the Check for Updates button. If any update is available, download and install the updates. Restart your PC for that. Now launch the game and see if this could resolve the issue. Method 11. Reinstall Nightingale. If the above methods cannot fix the issue, then reinstall Nightingale. To do so, press Windows plus I to open Settings. Open Apps and then head to Installed Apps. Click on the three-dot menu next to the game. Click on the Uninstall button. Follow as shown to uninstall the game. You can also reinstall the game from Steam. Here is how to do so. Go to Steam Library. Scroll through your list of games and choose Nightingale. Write on Nightingale, then click Manage. Then select Uninstall. click on uninstall again to confirm your action. Once the uninstallation of the game completes, restart your PC. Once your PC restarts, reinstall the game to some other drive or SSD. Now launch the game and check. And there you have it. The 11 methods to fix fail to open descriptor file error while launching Nightingale. We hope one of these methods have worked for you. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more tech tips and troubleshooting guides. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching, and we will see you in the next video.